Hey YouTubers, what's happening? Going from Advanced Plumbing. So you guys have seen I've made a plumbing channel in regards to doing pressure valves, thermostats. You'll see if you go on Advanced Plumbing on YouTube, you'll immediately see the channel. I think it's a brand new channel. We just started about a month ago, we started it, and there's a lot of useful information on it. So what I want you to do is go into YouTube, push Advanced Plumbing. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button because you're going to see a lot of awesome stuff coming in the future. You'd want to stay till the end of this video because I'm going to have a special announcement for you guys, and I want to hear what your feelings are, so you're welcome to comment. So today's tutorial, we're going to learn about where does your water come from in a plumbing system. Where does it come from? Where does it work? How does it work? Where does your hot water come from? Where does your drainage drain to? So I'm going to basically give you guys a full tutorial of how your plumbing system works. So today we're doing a whiteboard, so I'm not the best draftsman, so excuse my drawings. So what we're going to do here is how does your water come into your house. Okay, so basically we all know we open the tap and water magically appears, but do we know where the water come from? Do we know what's the technicalities of a plumbing system and how does it work? You know where your hot water comes from. So in this tutorial, we'll all explain what's going to happen there. So basically, we got a main pipe in the streets. Okay. Probably maybe like a 300 or even a 600 or 600 millimeter line. Okay, and that's from the municipal side, municipality. Okay. So what happens is your house is getting the water, they've got a saddle on their pipe, and there is your water meter. Okay. That's your water meter with your little dials and your numbers, whatever. Okay, and from here, this is where the magic happens. Your water pipe, so let's draw your house here. Let's just draw a basic house here. Okay. And we are going to have a garden tap, okay, and then we're going to have two taps in the house, cold, and then we're going to have another tap here, hot, okay, and then let's just extend this for demonstration purposes. Yeah, we're going to have what makes your water hot, the geyser. Okay, so basically what happens is you have a pipe coming from your mains into your house. This is normally 22 millimeters. Sometimes it is 15 millimeters, but that's not advised because you want water flowing, water volume. Okay. So what happens is this could either be a plasson pipe, plasson, or this could either be polycop. Many different pipes, but we're just going to discuss those two pipes today. So 22 millimeter will be a polycop, okay, and 25 will be plasson. Okay, so how does the water flow? So basically we have, I'm going to draw just a quick diagram. So this is where water flows. It goes into your house. Normally we have a problem when you shower and you actually, someone opens or flushes the toilet, you get burnt. And why is that? That's because the pressure is not balanced. So what you want to do to solve that problem is, where the water line goes exactly in your house, you want to have your PRV valve right there. Because what will that do? It will allow 400 or 600 kPa into your house. So don't worry about that too much. It's just the pressure rating for the geyser. If the geyser doesn't burst, then what the pressure rating is on the geyser. So basically what will happen is from the PRV valve, it will go into your garden tap. And then it will go into a T-piece here, which will go into your cold water. And then from there, maybe you've got another tap there. From there, it's linked with another T-piece that goes into your cold water supply over there. Okay. So, and then obviously from your PRV valve, it will go straight into your geyser, okay, with your vacuum breaker. Remember, it needs to be anti-siphonage loop. We're not going to get in that too much today. So, this is your cold water on your geyser. It's always at the bottom of your geyser, cold and hot. Okay. Your hot water is on top of your geyser. And then basically you've got your safety valve. You've got your safety valve over there. Or your hot water can even be there sometimes. Okay. So basically how your water flows from the meter, it goes to your PRV valve. It goes from your PRV valve into your garden tap. And then it branches up, goes to your cold water tap, branches off, goes to your other cold water tap. This is normally done in the roof, okay? And again, 22 millimeter copper piping in more modern houses, or 15 millimeter, but suggested 22 millimeter copper piping. On your geyser, you get different types of geyser. It could be quick hot geyser, or it could be a heat tech, or it could even be a durotherm geyser. We'll discuss in another video exactly what's the law requirements on replacing a new geyser, and why you need to be a qualified plumber to do that, and why you require a COC. So coming back to the drawing here, so basically your cold water system, very easy to understand, goes from your meter, goes your PRV valve, splits to your different points, obviously with different heights. Okay, now you want to know, how does hot water enter your house? Exactly the same thing, from your geyser, let's say for argument's sake, hot water comes here at the back of your geyser, and it goes there, it goes to your hot water tap. How does the water get hot? Inside the geyser, you've got an element, as we discussed in the tutorials. If you haven't seen all about elements, go into YouTube now, go watch the element video. You'll see exactly what size elements are required for what type of geyser. Okay, so, and then from your hot water, it will go from the back of the geyser into your taps. And then obviously, if you have another bathroom, then it will have a T-piece here, which goes into this tap over here. Have another bathroom there, we'll have a T-piece here that goes into that tap over there. Remember, have to have vacuum breakers on your geyser, but we'll discuss this in another video. I hope this is all making sense so far. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. And stay till the end, because it's a special announcement that you don't want to miss. So we have now an idea of how the water system works in your house. So we're going to clean the board off. Okay, clean the board off, not the penis sponge, but anyway, clean the board off here. So now that you know how the water system works in the house, we want to know, where does the water that goes out to your drains or run to? Okay, so yeah, we have a basin, okay, with the outlet here, we have a bath, an outlet over there, and we have a shower and an outlet over there. Okay, so basin, what you always want to remember is outlets on a basin will always be 40 millimeter PVC piping. Okay, on a bath, let's write this down so you can see it, 40 millimeter on a basin. On a bath, 50 millimeter on a bath. On a shower, 50 millimeter. Rules in plumbing, basin and shower can be connected, or into a junction, obviously, can be connected. Okay? Bath must always run out separate on a 50 mm line. So now that you understand, you need 40 mm PVC pipe for the overflow for your basin, 50 more for your shower. Basin and shower can run together, or you can run it out separately. It just depends on what's your application. And your bath is 50 millimeter PVC. Okay. So now we have all of this running. Okay. Let's just do this for interest sake. So inside, there by your kitchen, you've got a thing called a gully. This is where all your water runs through. All the water runs into there. Once you've drained your water. So now you want to know, where does this wastewater run, how does it work, and how does it actually get recycled? Okay, so interesting fact, the water that you've drank, you've probably drank twice before. So, meaning that, from the gully, you have, the gully trap looks like this, okay? Goes like that, basically. It's got a U like that, and then it goes up like that. So why does it have this? Why does it have this? I wonder who can tell me the answer. Write in the comments if you know. Who knows why a gully trap has this here? Why is it called a trap? What is the reason for it? I'm going to give you guys about 20 seconds to figure it out. And write in the comments what you think, and I'll give you the answer shortly. While we're busy, we'll come back to that. This is 110 millimeter PVC piping. Normally, UG. UG stands for underground. Okay. So what happens here is, let's say you've got a gully here by your kitchen. Okay. Then you have a toilet here, and then you have, say, another toilet over here, okay. And then also you have a dishwasher, okay, which is always going to just run into the gully. That's very simple to understand, it's not rocket science. Okay, so what happens here is, this pipe flows all the way like that. And then you have your toilet pipe, which flows into a junction, like that. Also, 110 millimeter. If it's above ground, this will be a SV pipe. SV pipe means swirl and vent. Okay? And why is it white? This is because it's UV protected. So the sun can't damage the pipe. And then you have another toilet over here, which flows into that, like that. And then obviously over here, you would have a vent valve, so you don't suck the trench dry. Okay, that we'll discuss in more other videos. We'll go into more detail in that. And then what happens with this water? So basically, let me tell you what the question that I asked. Why is this got a bend here? Why is that? So the reason for that is, so water can be trapped in there, because if there's no water trapped in there, what's going to happen? This is now your big square manhole in your yard where your drain line runs through, channels here, and then. So what happens is, if there's no water in here, what's going to happen? These fumes from the main line are going to come all the way back here, and you're going to have one solid stench coming through your gully. So trust me, this is not a nice smell. That's why there are traps there for the gullies, and that's what it's made for. Exactly the same with the 50 mils. There is always going to be either a P-trap or either a S-trap. Also again, P-trap, water, so the smell can't go through the drain. A water, so the smell can't go through the drain. So now that we understand that, what happens is, so now your toilet, so now you're flushing your toilet, so what happens, all the sewage runs there, it runs into here, and then it runs into a big main line, which gets transferred into the sewer farms. Remember I said you probably drank your water twice? This is what I'm saying. Water that gets flushed in the toilet goes to sewer farms, goes through a big chemical process, I'm not going to get into that, and it gets pumped back into the reservoir, and that's where your water comes from your house. So I hope if you guys like this video, again, give it a thumbs up, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and the announcements that you've all been waiting for now, thank you for waiting till the end, you guys are legends. If you guys want me to do a complete plumbing course for you, which will entail basically how the plumbing system works, it will give you all the videos, it will give you PDF documents that you can download, it will show you everything you need to know and learn to be a plumber. If you do my course, you could probably become a plumber in half time that other courses would take you, because I teach you exactly how it works to the point. You guys don't need any technical details right now, and my course is not technical at all, it's very easy to understand, as you can see all my videos. If you haven't watched my pressure videos, pressure valves, if you haven't watched the elements, you haven't watched the thermostats, go ahead please and watch that, and you will see how easy I explain things to you. Again, like this video, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching till the end, guys. Peace out.